How about Almog in Israel? Is it Almog?
Yeah.
Did I say it right?
Kinda. Almog, yeah.
Almog. Yeah.
Yeah, that's good.
All right. I can dig it. What do you want to talk about?
Hey, guys. First of all, I want to say that I really appreciate the show. I really like it. Really love the job that you're doing. It's amazing. And I'll ask for your... I will say sorry in advance for my English, and I'm a bit excited, but I'll try to pour my thoughts on you.
It's all good. What's up?
So I live in Israel, and I'm an atheist, and I want to like tell you a bit out of field and get what you're thinking, and maybe some tips about living as an atheist in a very theist environment. And well, I know my country is not like Iran or Iraq or something, and it's like there's like worse religion country, but still it's a very religion country, and my family is religion. And I heard you once say be a good person, do good stuff, let them see that atheists are good people. But like I don't get religion forced over me every day and day, but still, I feel so alone in this country, in this society. I feel that most of the people don't understand me. I feel that it's really hard to find common ground. And where I live in the north of the country, it's really hard. And you know, I was saying it to the screen callers, some situation that I get often, and I'm a bit ashamed to say it, and you'll understand in a second why, because I know religion people could be intelligent people, smart people, funny people, because religion doesn't mean anything, and religion is a really, really good brainwash. But sometimes when I meet a person and I'm having fun with him, and suddenly I will see he's like wearing a cross necklace or something like that, something that is very religion, I will get some antagonism feeling from him. I will get, maybe I don't like this person more as I think I do, because he's believing in stuff that is, like, I don't know. I don't know if it sounds weird or not, but, and sometimes I even think farther and thinking about immigration, like, maybe I should go to a country when I feel there's a lot of people around me that I can get along with, that I don't need to feel that weird and that different in the environment. And I don't know, what do you guys think about that?
Yeah, well, I think that if you have the opportunity and the resources to move, and where you're living right now isn't making you feel at home, then that's definitely an option that I would suggest. I've moved around quite a lot, not to different countries, but around the United States. And yeah, there are some places where I felt completely ostracized and very different and very much like I was an outsider and I couldn't really open up to people because I was an atheist. And I got out of those places as soon as I could. And sometimes it was financially feasible and sometimes it wasn't. But yeah, I think that moving is an option. Insofar as making snap judgments about people based on whether or not they're religious, I understand. I do the same thing sometimes, especially on like dating apps. If somebody is a Christian on a dating app, I will generally not even interact with them. But that doesn't say anything bad about them. I just think that probably we have views of the world or values that are going to clash. And so maybe it's not so much of a you aren't a good person, or you're not as good a person as me. It's more of you're not a good person for me, if that makes sense.
Yeah. But I think dating is like one step ahead. Like, let me ask you the same question about friends. Like, you sit in a bar and you're starting to get along someone really well, and you think you're gonna be best friends, and then like you reveal that he's very religion. Do you still keep on trying to make bonding with him, or you'll just
I've had best friends that were very, very Christian. You know, people are different, and just because they believe a thing does not mean that they are a certain kind of person. We are so very different that I think we need to be cognizant of taking the moral high road, because what we're speaking out about over here in Texas, in the United States, is that the other way around, there are people who write us off because they think that they know who we are.
Mm-hmm.
We had King Kong call in earlier, and we want to be exemplars of that, that there are plenty of people who can have different faith backgrounds who maybe just, hey, this is how I was raised, or hey, you know, this cross necklace is meaningful to me. I actually have a friend who has a cross necklace that they wear, not because that they believe, but because it has a significance to them with someone that they love. Don't write them off right away. When it comes to your love life, for those kinds of things, absolutely. If I'm on Tinder and I see somebody who's wearing a cross necklace, I'm going to swipe left. Yeah, but that's ultimately because this is such an integral part of my life that it would be very difficult to have conversations with somebody that don't involve this. I'm kind of one-track minded right now. This is where my career is going, and so it's a whole lot more powerful. But you may be robbing yourself of opportunities to meet wonderful people and to be a good example with them too. You know, don't write them off right away. You know, give people the opportunity to live up to what they can be and show you who they are. We don't want to segment ourselves away.
Yeah, I'm totally agree. When I'm thinking about it, I know that's the right thing to do, but it's kind of like unconscious feeling that like bubble inside me when I see it. It's like suddenly I don't like them as much as I did before. It's all funny and stupid, but yeah, I know that. That's the right thing to do, to give them the chance. They could be wonderful people. They can be smart. They can be funny. We can have a good time, even though we don't agree on something. And yeah, what do you guys think? Like, there are like major tips for me surviving out here, or don't you think that like immigration is like running away? Because like I don't know. I really feel weird about going out of my country because I'm an atheist. It's gonna sound extreme to me, although as you said, V, if you're not feeling well in your environment, it's kind of sounded like the logical thing to do, but it still sounds extreme, so
yeah.
I'm a bit confused.
No, a move can be scary. It can be a very big step, and you would have to weigh the options, which one would make you more uncomfortable, and would that be more discomfort in the short run for more comfort in the long run? Or more comfort now for a long time of discomfort following. I do want to echo what Eric said, but I do want to also say that the accepting people who are religious as people who can be close to you only goes so far as their acknowledgement of your right to exist and your right to exist safely. So if you are concerned about your safety with somebody, or you don't know how they would respond if you told them you were an atheist and if that would be a negative or violent response, then you have every right to not only be cautious when approaching religious people, but also to cut off relationships with people who would not be beneficial for you in that way. So yes, definitely give people the benefit of the doubt. Religion does not make a person good or bad. That's a religious concept, one that we don't subscribe to. If your safety is ever in question, you come first.
Absolutely. But we're running short on time, but hopefully that helped, man.
Yeah, actually that's really helped. It's good to talk with atheists people around the world to share a bit my feeling. And I really love the show, guys. Appreciate everything you're doing. Keep up the good job.
Will do.
Thanks
will do.
Thank you.
Look up atheist skeptic groups in your area.
Yes.
Because there probably are some. It's surprising to see, but definitely check it out. And also, you can be anywhere in the world and hop on our Discord. We're going to be there in about a little over 10 minutes talking to people. So tiny.cc/ACA Discord. Come and join us. There are tons of other atheists that you can talk to as well. But take care, man.
Yeah, you too, guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I